You know, the day's still a pup. It's still morning, not afternoon. It's 27 minutes past 11. Now, marketing is an established tool. It's there to help business increase profits. But it's fair to say that for most people going into a small business for the first time, marketing's probably a grey area. Because when we think marketing, advertising comes to mind, radio, press, television. But there is more to marketing than just that. And local businesswoman Samantha Reese has just released her new self-help guide, Boost Your Company's Profit, to help people in business do just that. So if you're in business, I hope this chat is of benefit to you. Samantha, a very good morning.
Good morning to you, George.
Perhaps a little about yourself, Samantha.
So I actually ran a marketing business for 12 years, and prior to that have worked in marketing for about 13 years. And when I started my business, I guess I was very fortunate that I had been trained in marketing. So I kind of like understood what you should kind of like do to actually kind of like create a business and move forward. But it became very evident when I worked with other businesses that was not the case. Mm. Most of the businesses were actually specialists in IT or specialists in planning, and they decided to open a business and didn't actually have business skills behind them. And so I came on board and actually helped those businesses to actually move forward.
All right. Now, is it fair to suggest that our conversation this morning will be a benefit not only to the larger, but also to the small business?
Well, correct, because it's important. When you're a small business, you can do a lot of other things such as Facebook nowadays, which is a very good medium to communicate with your audience or your database and maintain a presence of mind. The thing is that you have to actually do it consistently. It's a bit like exercise or weight loss. You know, you can't stop and start. You get stop-start results. Yeah. It's actually something you have to do all year round, but just choose what you're going to do and then stick to it. That's a simple thing.
So a business's marketing strategy is very important.
Well, I think it underlies, in fact, what you're going to stock, what you're going to, in terms of price point, who your customers are, how you're going to place that product in the shelf or in the service sector, and then basically how you're going to promote your business. So I believe that marketing is actually the engine that drives a business.
Okay. So in your guide, you say most business thinks only of press, TV, radio. So how much more is there?
Well, there's business to business. There's social media, of course. There's events. There's direct mail. There's also catalogues if you're in retail. There's also press editorials rather than actually advertising. What I think actually happens is that, you know, a radio rep or a press rep turn up on someone's door. They knock on the door and say, do you want to do an advertising campaign? The business owner goes, oh, okay, yeah, all right, why not? Don't think about what they want to say. Don't think about what makes them special or why people should choose them first. They do it for a week. Generally, they get a week's worth of results. But like I say in my book, when I ran my business, I wanted results 52 weeks of the year, not just 1 week. So yes, I think a press or a radio or a TV advertising campaign has its place if you're that kind of company, but it has to be part of an overall mix. Don't just rely on that one thing to create this sudden boom in revenue. It will not be the case.
Of course, small business in particular, you know, is really focused sharply on getting the business up and running. And for a lot of people, there aren't enough hours in the day as it is. And, you know, when you start talking marketing strategies, they go, oh, no, leave me alone. You know, I'm up to here as it is.
Yes. I understand that situation and that franticness that goes with running a business. But I'm a big believer that if you actually set aside 2 days, and I've actually put in my book what to include in a marketing strategy. If you set aside 2 days and you actually then plan a 12-month campaign, you just have to put down each month what you're doing, when you're doing it, and you follow that plan. It's just like everything else then in your business. It just becomes part rigmarole of what you do. I think the other thing too is that a business, you need to be focused on where you're taking your business. If you don't know where you want to go, and that means revenue, if you don't know that you want to increase revenue by $100,000, then you just become part of a doldrum. It becomes a groundhog day. So I think it's very important that when you're actually running a business, that you can look at the end of each day and go, right, did I make my sales targets? And if I made my sales targets, that's good. If I didn't, what do I have to do tomorrow to help me? So it's actually a very motivating factor to actually keep going in your business. The other thing too is that, you know, I worked with an irrigation company, and we just did two things in their business. We actually packaged their little sprinkler heads into packs of 10, put an extra dollar on that, right, rather than selling them individually. And we actually then spoke with companies that offered discounts if you paid your invoice early. And we put those two things in place, and within 3 months they were making a profit. So it's not necessarily about promoting yourself. It's also about looking internally at your business and what you can do to basically cut costs and make more money that way as well.
See, for a lot of people, they go into business Probably because they're sick of working for someone else.
Correct.
And they buy into a business, and there is that sort of settling in period, which is a euphoric period. It's a new thing in their life.
Honeymoon.
It is the honeymoon. The novelty is there, and they're putting in 25 hours a day to the exclusion of everything else. And then all of a sudden, the reality sets in.
Correct.
That we're not making the money that we thought we were going to make. So it must be very difficult for somebody to, in the first place, set out a strategic plan before launching into their business.
Well, I agree, but it's all about actually having the right information to help you guide your decisions. And that's why I've actually written this book, is specifically to actually allow people to read it in a very much a coaching role in that book. So they read it and they go, okay, if that's what I've got to do, then I've got to do it, right? The thing is that when you run a business, you have to be disciplined. You can't be lackadaisy.
No.
It's your money that you're making or not in this case. So if you know what you have to do, and a lot of the times when I work with businesses, they actually knew what was going wrong with their business. They just actually lacked the motivation or even sometimes the guts to actually put it into place. At the end of the day, you've got to be tough on your business to make it work for you. If you're going to be wishy-washy, your business will be wishy-washy. If you're decisive about where you're going and you take it there, then you'll get the results.
It is 27 minutes to 12, and I'm speaking with Samantha Rees. I hope you're enjoying the conversation, particularly if you are in business, because there are always ways that you can improve your business. Do many companies realise that they should do something but don't know how to go about it?
Yeah, so they then rely heavily on, you know, the advertising agencies, and as I said in the book, sometimes those advertising agencies get kickbacks for actually placing advertising in TV or radio. And so when I ran my company, we had a policy where we didn't take those kickbacks, so it was actually a genuine reason why we put the advertising in those mediums. I do think, though, that if you're clever enough to start a business, and if you've got the guts to start a business, then you're clever enough to actually make a strategy. I'm not talking about a 50-page document. Mm. It can be a couple of pages where you go, who's my client? How am I going to get them to know about me? When am I going to do it? What's it going to cost? Because the other thing too is that a lot of companies I start working with marketing, they get this first surge in sales and they say, all right, well, we can stop now. But I used to say, well, that's the sign that you're on the right direction.
Yeah.
Don't stop. Keep going, because if you keep going, then you'll actually reach your target. So the temptation often is they do a little bit of marketing, they get the results, they think, right, I'm on easy street now, I can glide the rest of the way. But anyone who runs a small business knows there is no such thing as easy street. You get the benefits from running a business, but you have to put the hard work in.
All right, Samantha. A marketing strategy, is it ongoing?
Of course, yes. So I do believe that if you want ongoing results, then you actually have to be doing something virtually every day. So I do a Facebook page update every day. I've had people say to me, oh, that's so time consuming. Well, I say to them, well, then sit down on a Sunday with a glass of wine and write the whole week's worth of messages that you want and then cut and paste them every day. Right? I actually feed into a variety of sites that give me inspiration for what I should be saying on my Facebook page. Write press releases, plan them out. You know, what are you going to be saying? Have you got, you know, a new sponsorship that you're doing? Are you getting on new staff? Are you basically awarded a big contract? These are all mechanisms to get press coverage for. So there's a lot of things that you probably are doing in your business that's noteworthy and worth promoting, but it's a matter of just sitting down, taking the time to step out of the business and work on the business rather than in the business.
Right. Staff involvement, like if you're in the business, you must involve the staff.
I'm a big believer that you've got to share your vision with the staff. You know, if you're going to sell the business, don't share that, obviously. But, you know, if you want your staff to work with you to achieve the targets, especially sales targets, then, you know, I used to say to my staff, you need to bill X amount a day. And we had billing sheets. And that's what they build. So if you set those paradigms around your staff, you encourage your staff. I work with quite a few retailers here in Bunbury. And so we used to do little incentives, like if they, you know, if we had some TVs that we had to sell, for example, I would put $10, $50 notes on the board. And I'd say, right, when you sell one of those TVs, yes, they're full price, yes, but, you know, if you sell one of those, you can take home that 50 buck note. And so you have to motivate your staff. Mm. And that takes energy, obviously. And I find that if you need assistance, go and attend courses, go and attend conferences, network, talk about these things. It gives you inspiration.
It's lovely talking to a motivated person, Samantha. Your book, Boost Your Company's Profits, so where is it available?
So you can get it into any of the bookshops, otherwise amazon.com.au, of course.